Dear friends, today I am going to discuss about whether CSR expenditure made as donations be qualified for deduction under Section 80G of the Income Tax Act very soon. Mandatory CSR spending. Section 135(5) states that the board of every company referred to in subsection 1 shall ensure that the company spends in every financial year at least 2% of the average net profits of the company made during the 3 immediately preceding financial years in pursuance of its corporate social responsibility policy. While such companies are required to make this CSR spending compulsorily, the Finance No. 2 Act 2014 restricted its deduction for tax purpose by amending the Section 37 subsection 1 of the Income Tax Act of 1961. No specific tax exemption. There is no specific tax exemption that has been extended to expenditure incurred for CSR or as of now. However, spending on several activities which are governed by section other than Section 37(1) of the IT Act could be claimed as deduction. One of these sections is 80G of the IT Act. However, the claim under the 80G of the IT Act is not free from litigation. In recent case, Goldman Sachs Services Private Limited versus JCIT Bangalore, an interesting question was raised whether the expenses incurred to fulfill the CSR obligation under Companies Act 2013 could be claimed as deduction under Section 80G of the IT Act. Goldman Sachs in the year 2014-15 spent rupees 2.25 crores towards CSR and claimed rupees 1.12 crore as the deduction under Section 80G of the Income Tax Act. However, the tax officer denied the tax claim under Section 80G of the Income Tax Act except for contribution made to PM National Relief Fund. Dispute Resolution Panel, DRP, confirmed the tax office action and DRP observed that the claim are in the nature of CSR policy expenditure and hence does not qualify for deduction under Section 80G of the Income Tax Act. Explanation to the Section 37(1) of the Income Tax Act. IT Tribunal, Bangalore held that CSR expenses are mandatorily to be incurred by companies in terms of Section 135 of the Companies Act 2013. Deduction under Section 37(1) of the IT Act is not available in the light of the Explanation 2 of the Section 37(1) of the IT Act. Explanation 2 narrates that for the removal of doubt, it is hereby declared that for the purpose of the Section 1, Subsection 1, any expenditure incurred by an assessee on the activities relating to the corporate social responsibility referred to in Section 135 of the Companies Act 2013 will not be deemed to be an expenditure incurred by the assessee for the purpose of the business or profession. So, here's an explanation clearly states any expenses made under the Section 135 of the Companies Act shall not be deemed or shall not be construed to be expenditure incurred by the assessee for the purpose of the business or so. CSR expenditure, as per the above explanation, is not a business expenses or professional expenses. So this is very strange. CSR spending is not a voluntary donation. In the present case, the tax officer has rejected the tax panel's claim under the Section 80G of the IT Act without verifying the nature of the contribution and observed that it is not a donation. So, 80G speaks only about donation and tax officer in this case states the CSR contribution is not a donation and was not spent voluntarily basis for the eligibility of the claim under the Section 80G of the Act, but due to legal obligation prescribed under the Section 135 of the Companies Act 2013. So, in this case, the tax officer differentiated between voluntary contribution and legal mandatory obligation. Further, after examining the Section 80G of the IT Act, the Tribunal, Bangalore Tribunal, Tax Tribunal observed that in respect of the following donations, it is specifically provided that if they are incurred in pursuance of the CSR, deduction under Section 80G of the Act will not be available to the following: Swachh Bharat Kosh and Clean Ganga Fund. The Tribunal observed that While these two exemptions are provided in Section 80G of the IT Act, it can be referred that other contribution made under the Section 135(5) of the CE Companies Act are also eligible for the deduction under the Section 80G of the IT Act, subject to taxpayers satisfying the other conditions, the requisite conditions prescribed for deduction under the Section 80G of the Act. This is very important observation. The Tax Tribunal Bangalore observed that these two exceptions are provided under Section 80G of the Act. It can be referred that the other contribution made under Section 135 of the Act are also eligible. When this Swachh Bharat Ghosh and Clean Ganga is also eligible for 80G, why not the other contribution? That is the observed by the Bangalore Tax Tribunal, as the tax officer did not deal with these aspects and merely considered the contribution as not voluntary but a legal obligation under CSR policy, the tribunal remanded back to the tax officer for fresh examination and verification of the facts, subject to taxpayer satisfying the requirements of the 80G of the IT Act. The main intention of the Bangalore Tax Tribunal is, when Swachh Bharat and other is qualifying for 80G, why not other contribution like CSR contribution also should qualify for this? So tax officer has to re-examine the point and subject to the available satisfying the requirement under Section 80G of the IT Act. Findings. Tribunal has made an important observation that CSR spending, even though made under the legal obligation under Section 135 of the Section Companies Act 2013, can be claimed as deduction under Section 80G of the IT Act, except for Swachh Bharat and Clean Ganga Fund, subject to fulfillment of conditions prescribed in the Section 80G of the IT Act. This ruling, that is Bangalore Tax Tribunal ruling, will give respite to the many taxpayers who have incurred CSR expenditure in accordance with the Companies Act 2013 and are covered by the Section 80G of the IT Act. The first American India Private Limited in ACIT Bangalore Tax Tribunal held that taxpayers are denied the benefit of deduction under Section 80G of the IT Act merely because such payments form the part of the CSR spending. It would lead to double disallowance, which is not the intention of the legislature. So in this case also, Bangalore Tax Tribunal has observed properly that any deduction under 80G should also be allowed as a deduction. And if they disallow it, then it will tantamount to double disallowance, which is not the intention of the legislature. While the judiciary is still evolving on tax deductibility of CSR spending, in light of the recent ruling, it could be that is the recent ruling by the Tax Tribunal Bangalore, it can be construed that the amendment made to the Section 80G of the IT Act, or Finance Act of 2015, should be interpreted in a literal manner, and contribution made to any fund or institution other than Swachh Bharat Ghosh and Clean Ganga Fund, which qualify as a CSR spending under Section 135 of the Section Companies Act 2000, would be eligible for deduction under the Section 80G of the Act. Let us wait and see how this tax dispute is going to be decided in Feb. I think it should be extended to the deduction under the Section 80G should be as a business expenditure should be allowed to the spending on CSR also. So that is the intention of the legislature. Let us wait and see how this final decision of the tax officer of Bangalore has to come back. Friends, thanking you once again, I request you to subscribe my channel so that whenever I issue new topics on various videos, it will reach you directly. Thanking you once again, R.V. Shekhar, Practicing Company Secretary.